the lighting usually breaks in the elevator. I'm talking fast, I don't want it to open up. But today I'm gonna be taking you along with me for a little week in my life. You'll see me as a student for the first time, so that's exciting. So you'll be following along.
Darling, you send me. Darling, you.
So I just bought food from this food truck for the first time, and I got a blueberry mint lemonade. I wanted to try it on camera. Oh my god.
My life has changed. I just walked like a mile and a half and like did a bunch of things, but I have something crazy to tell you. Like, I don't even believe that it happened. You're not gonna believe that it happened. Nobody's gonna believe that it happened. So I'm gonna tell you later.
Lighting in this hallway is like pretty bad, but I just got in from class. I have food that I'm gonna eat. Lots of 13 reasons why. And then I'm gonna tell you my story and tell you the plan for the rest of the day and like kind of walk you through how this week is gonna go. Because I get to bed this morning because I was running late, as usual. Okay, I'm about to walk in my door. I'm tired. My day is nearly done. So, yes, I will talk to you in a moment after I eat this food. And I got like a chicken, pesto chicken salad thing, and it was really, really good from the food truck that you saw earlier. Okay, so I want to tell you my story. But first, after I tell you my story, I'm going to be driving to Johns Hopkins. I'm the co-president of Charles R. Drew Pre-Health Society, so we're going to visit JHU as like a programming event. So that's going to be the rest of my day, and then after that I need to come home and write a paper that's due tomorrow. I started it, but I have to finish it. Here's my story. Let me set the scene. So I'm walking to class, you see my feet probably, and then I opened up a door to the building where my first class was. You see me open up the door. You see me enter a stairwell. And then I enter the stairwell, and then from the stairwell there's another door that leads into the hallway. So I'm about to go and like open the door, and I look down and there's little feet. There's little feet like under the door moving. And I'm looking and I'm like, another thing, I'm extremely afraid of bugs. Like that's really my only fear in life. So anyways. I'm sitting here like, is there a bug? Like, what's going on? But they were like feet. So I'm like, okay, bugs will have feet. So, and there's a long tail. So then it like scurries under the door. So I'm like, oh my god, is it a rat? I'm not afraid of rats, but they don't belong in the buildings that I attend class in. So I open the door. There's two doors. They're like double doors. So I open the door that like, the side that it didn't go under. And I see it was a lizard. There was a lizard in my building scurrying around freely. And I literally was like, and then I kept walking. And I turned around like five times and I was like, what is going on? No one was around. No one else saw. I'm thinking someone had a pet lizard and it escaped and I got out. But okay, I'm gonna go. Hopefully I still have credibility after this. I'll see you maybe in Baltimore. I just wanted to give you a little update because I didn't get to say good morning this morning. I didn't get to say good night. But you saw some clips of me and some members of my pre-health org at Johns Hopkins. We took a tour of the anatomy lab. We took a tour of the main School of Medicine building, and then we also listened in on a panelist of medical students from different years. And it was actually so great. And I didn't even think about Johns Hopkins just because they're very like research focused, Well, I assume they were very research focused, and I'm just not as into research. Johns Hopkins just really seems like they care about their students doing well. They care about them having a community of students, but also they have like mentors that they keep for 4 years. So yeah, I just thought it was really, really great. Everyone who went that was a member really enjoyed the event, so that was really nice. Then I came home. So I drove to and from Baltimore, exhausting. And then I came home and I had to write a paper. I haven't finished my paper, it was late, I was exhausted. Like, I couldn't even pick up my phone and say goodnight. So sorry about that. But today's a very special day because we're on the third week of school, second day of the third week. And today is the first day that I don't have to go anywhere after classes. I'm actually in for the rest of the night. I'm so, so, so excited and so grateful that like every piece of my schedule and every activity that I do has given me a break.
Hi guys, it's almost 2. I just brushed my teeth and I washed my hair. As you can see, it's looking pretty good. I'm using this new technique of applying my products after I wash my hair. And I feel like it's really helpful. Brush my teeth, I'm about to throw my hair up in a pineapple, and go to sleep. I have a big day tomorrow with First Look Fair, so I need all the sleep I can get. Good night, and I'll see you tomorrow for day 3 of this walk.
Good morning, guys. Here is my little outfit of the day. Because I'm tabling for First Look Fair. I'm gonna show you what First Look Fair is, but essentially it's like this fair where usually like underclassmen come and there's all these orgs and then they can find out which org is best for them. So yes, I'll be tabling for my sorority, and then I'm also, you're gonna see a little shirt change and also a sunglasses change for the culture, because I'll be tabling for Charles R. Drew, my pre-health organization as well. So I will see you out there. Hey guys, I just changed shirts. I'm repping CRD now. I'm gonna table until like literally for 5 minutes, and then I'm going to class. I have my first kines lab today, and then I'm gonna be tabling again, and then going to my last class, and then I will be free. Anyways, here we go. I bought some kava at one of my favorite restaurants here, and I'm gonna eat. I don't know what I'm gonna watch because 13 Reasons Why is over, and nothing will ever be the same. So I have to find a show. Pretty sad. Yeah. I also plan on taking a nap because I'm exhausted. I need to do my biochem notes today, retake them. Like, it's essential that it gets done today because we learned all the amino acids yesterday, all 20. And to review that, clearly. But yes, okay, I'm gonna nap. I'm really excited. Home and like in the air conditioning. It was 93 degrees today. And then there was a warning in the weather app that said, if you're a part of a vulnerable population, then the air quality will be like not good enough for you. And it's like, oh good. It's Thursday, our last day of classes. Today is our long day though. We have classes straight through from 9:30 to 3. And then I wanted to stay, like, do some work before I come home. Because when I come home, Netflix turns on. It's just an issue. But we also have our first e-board meeting of the year. So it should be a pretty busy day, pretty long day. But I'm excited. So let's go for it. First e-board meeting, we're super excited. And also we've dubbed Thursdays Dessert Thursdays, right? You agree with the notion?
Potentially.
Say yay or nay.
The kinks first.
This is probably never seen a bitch better than me.
I'm gonna have to cut out the cursor.
Oh my god, are you like a family channel?
No!
Oh, we're family!
The E and Kev.
Architecture podcast?
No.
Political podcast.
Oh. So it's Friday at 2:00. This lighting is amazing. As you can see, I'm still in my pajamas. My hair is still in a pineapple. My glasses are still on. I've been in my bed basically all day. I just had some breakfast. I just had some cream of wheat. And now I'm doing my biochem homework. It's due today at midnight. Today's not going to be too exciting of a day because I work from 4 to 10 and I'm probably not going to bring you to work because it's not going to be interesting. And then after work, I'll probably just come home and like eat and watch like Netflix for a little bit. I doubt if I'll do any work. I'll probably be pretty tired. But I usually would end the vlog on Thursday. Today's Friday. I don't have class on Friday. But I'm continuing it because tomorrow is Saturday and I'm doing community service with my sorority, and it's here on campus, but it's kind of like a clinical dental type community service. So I just thought it'd be really interesting if I can film anything with that. So that's why the vlog is going to be a little extra long for this week in my life. But yeah, I'm on question 19 out of 31 for this homework. Hope I will see you later. I'm on my way to work. I watched my show for 13 minutes between homework and getting ready. Happy Friday to me. Good morning, guys. It's Saturday, the last day of this vlog. I'm on my way to work again. You didn't see me last night after work just because I was really tired. So I just like had through my problems, left a biochem, finished that, ate food, watched my new show, Tuca and Birdie, and then I went to bed. So it was really nothing to film. I'm going to work now for 6 hours, and then before I get off, I'm going to community service right after, and then Kurt's supposed to stop by later. That's what my day is looking like. Hello! So it is like almost 4:49, I'm off work. Quickly changed clothes. I'm into some paraphernalia and I'm on my way to community service. Hopefully it's on campus. So I hope I can vlog something while I'm there.
I'm here with some of my sorority sisters. This is Kennedy. And we're doing some service, cleaning up from the aftermath of the dental clinic. Saturday. Hi. Did you get a haircut? He's out there pumping my gas like the gentleman he was raised to be. Your man should be pumping your gas. But we're on our way to get Sardi's. which is like this really good restaurant around here. We're super excited. We're just gonna get takeout because we always get takeout, and then we'll probably watch like X on the Beach. But the Stardies, I'm super excited for because it's so yummy, and it's the type of restaurant where when you eat it, it feels like you're almost eating like a home cooked meal. Like, it's so filling and just the flavors all together. Oh, yeah, it's really great. Community service was good. Basically, my sorority and I, we cleaned up the floor after all the dental procedures were complete. We just like broke everything down, wiped everything down, put things in the trash, organized equipment that needed to be sterilized, and all of that. So it was pretty nice. Took some pictures. You got to meet one of my sweaty sisters. Her won't be here that long because he's traveling tomorrow for work. So once he leaves, I'm either gonna hang out with Kennedy, who you saw earlier, or I'm just gonna do my favorite thing, which is go home and lay in my bed and watch Tuca and Birdie. We'll see if I get any work done today. I need to get work done today, but if not, tomorrow I'm actually not doing anything. It's the first day I haven't done anything, including go to class, because tomorrow's Sunday, probably in a month. So tomorrow I plan on only doing homework. Do you think all men should pump their women's gas?
It depends on the relationship. But there's no reason that my girl should get off the car to pump gas, especially late at night.
You heard it here first, people.
White rice and mashed potatoes, please.
You want a gravy on the mashed potatoes?
No, thank you.
My hair is up. My glasses are on. It's about 2:30 a.m. Kirk, I think the last time you saw me was when I was getting Sardis and then went over one of my sorority sisters' apartments and hung out with a couple of them. And then we all fell asleep over there, so yeah. Now I'm back in my apartment. I'm super, super tired. I can barely keep my eyes open, but I wanted to film a little outro for this vlog. I really hope you enjoyed it, and if you liked this video, comment and subscribe. And I will see you in my next one.
24/7, 365. Right after me, where I feel your sunshine.